My name is David Hillier. I'm the Associate Principal of the University and also the Executive Dean of Strathclyde Business School, where all our graduates are graduating from today. On behalf of the whole university, I want to welcome you here to the Barony Hall, which is one of the gems in Strathclyde's crown. On the stage today, we have members of staff who have taught you over the last year, and in some cases more than a year. But we also have members and representatives from our university court and also our students' association as well. It's a really special day. So for those of you that get the graduates who are ready to come up onto the stage, just relax. And for the family and friends who are here, relax as well. You know, for graduations, you only get once or twice in your life. And so in a sense, it's a bit like a wedding. And so in that spirit, really enjoy it. If you want to celebrate and you want to celebrate in your own way, then feel free to do so. It really enhances the atmosphere. So in a couple of minutes, each graduate is going to come up onto the stage, and they're going to walk towards me, and I will cap them. I have the honour of capping them. And that is a tradition that goes back to the founding of this university in 1796. And these ceremonies, they're known as commencement ceremonies in many countries, and it's because we're not celebrating the end of a journey. We're celebrating that transition, which happens at the capping, to a new start, a commencement of a new journey, a new chapter in our graduates' lives. And our graduates will become graduates, and they'll join over 200,000 Strathclyders around the world. And wherever you go around the world, in any business or organisation, you'll always tend to find a Strathclyder. And that's what we call ourselves. So, and we don't just say the graduates are Strathclyders, actually the families are Strathclyders as well. So we're increasing the size of our family every time we have these graduations. So without further ado, I'm now going to invite Professor Susan Howick, who is the Vice Dean of Strathclyde Business School, to present our graduates.
Associate Principal and Executive Dean, in the name of the University and by the authority of Senate, I present to you these students. For the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, for research in the Department of Accounting and Finance, Hesham Ali Ahmed Ali. For the degree of Master of Philosophy, for research in the Department of Accounting and Finance, Sakshi Munat. The degree of Master of Science in Finance, Ramesh Babu Alagatla Rajendran. Iyulawa Dorcas Iyanulawa. Mohammed Fizizada. Mehul Goel. Fayaz Thusuf Khan. Harshit Kurana. Vaibhav Sanji Lange. Vishnavi Vijayan Nair. Thu Deu Nguyen. Abhishek Binodkumar Patel. Pranav Vinod Patil. Mohit Monoj Rora. Oviya Selvamani. Atif Mohammed Akil Sheikh. Trisha Ramkrishna Shetty. Ayushman Singh. Gurav Srivastava. Martin Stevenson. In finance and management, Claire Brough. Sakshi Gupta. Yukta Gupta. Ritusha Harish. Thapana Hirabat. Palak Jain. Jennifer Lafferty. Soumya Misra. Jitesh Mahesh Motwani. Arti Nugpur. Tepeathep Nakarash. Purva Anil Rakid. Marvin Rowan. Anvi Jatin Rapawala. In financial technology, Priya Sunil Agarwal. Shruti Dhananjay Chait. Nagok Ann Chu. Sharia Kumar Dubey. Luke Xavier Fairburn. Jose Ernesto Gonzalez Garcia. Joel Cata. Jack William Kerrison. Niall Lawrence. Nuseba Mohammed. Osama Morjani. Pham Ha Duong. Sirtip Ratana Ari. Akshay K. Salunk. Jetsarid Tanuwarapong. Srikanth Vamadevan. In international accounting and finance, Phyllis Ansah. Jensing Dong. Mohan Raj Gangadhara. Syed Jemal Hassan. Sara Hedayati. How you who? Yiming Hu. Shruti Santosh Kadam. Harsh Jayesh Kapadia. Eamon Naeem Mustafa. Eunice Phillips. Iswarya Prakash. Swastika Devi Prasad Shastri. Sarah Michelle Thane. In international banking and finance, Callum McMillan. Vikas Kumar Singh. Divrashi Samapa. In investment and finance, Komal Sanjay Agarwal. Shaili Agarwal. Yogita Agrawal. Anaka Nizam. Hanil Bandari. Urmila Ashwarlal Bora. Sarah Nafisa Butchakur. Angshuman Das. Andrew Gilfeather. Akshay Gowder. Abhishek Ananthanarayanan Iyer. Atul Ajay Karkir. Mohammed Alimuddin Khan. Abhijit Kumar. Stacey Kuyiwawa. Keir Alexander McKenzie. Regan McBeath. Nguyen Can Linh. Nguyen Thai Phuong Nhi. John Connor Oates. Priyadarshan Nitin Raut. Hetvi Manish Shah. Ankit Shrivastava. Ravjeet Singh. Margaret Mary Smith. Bruce Angus Sorby. Angus Stewart. Yosanin Ying Yung Yong. In strategic fintech, Fatima Alkabaz. Ahmed Garashi. Rabia Saeed. For the degree of Master in International Business with a Modern Language, Nikki Thien. For the degree of Bachelor of Arts in Accounting and Finance, Hassan El Noor Youssef. In Finance, Michael Lees. Christopher Riley. Hongyi Chen. In Finance and Business Law, Louis Ryder. In Finance and Economics, Godfrey Elia Nicolacosa. Lyle Craig. In Finance and Human Resource Management, Lucy Graham. Eamon Saif. In Finance and Marketing, Lewis Alfred Ian Bryce Maynard. In Economics, Camelia Spasova Georgieva. In Economics and Mathematics and Statistics, Humaid Harith Humaid Al Amari. In Business Enterprise, Jamie Cabangle. In Business Enterprise and Economics with International Study, Eric Wei Lan Chia. In Business Analysis and Technology and Business Law, Abigail Sterling. In Business Analysis and Technology and Mathematics and Statistics, Alexandra Elizabeth Brown. In Marketing, Fraser George Morrison. Alistair Russell. in International Business, Zayed Jamal Salem Obeid Al-Tahariri. In International Business with Marketing, Zoe Cairns Alice Kant. Reni Raju Mahindru. In Business Management, Stephanie Cassidy. Emma Cousin. Karen Ann Duffy. Jamie George Forsyth. Nichelle Gill. Rona Ann Martin. Scott Kerr Motion. Gary Neal. Craig Patterson. Robert Campbell Dundas Beveridge. Jordan James Fairlamb. Mukesh Gupta. Jennifer Miller. Nadine Orr. Pauline Murdoch Tuthill. Rebecca Young. Ross Heggie. Cameron James Watson. Stephen Anderson. Ciara Rachel Campbell. Joanne Lee Dunbar. Natalie Irvine. Ben Irving. Margaret April McQueen. Louise Morley. Jamie Ronald Naismith. Elizabeth O'Keefe. Deborah Aitchison Riddell. John Joseph Alexander Sharp. Wam Saluka. Jamie Robert Spence. Julie Stevenson. Corin J. Strain. Ian William Thompson. Thomas Thompson. Stephen Voss. Christopher Scott Wiley. In Human Resource Management, James Hilton. In Human Resource Management and Marketing, Katie Louise Hepburn. Stephen James Joseph Smith. For the degree of Bachelor of Business Administration, Adil Mayo Neng. Pooja Rajan. For the degree of Bachelor of Arts in Business Analysis and Technology and Business Enterprise, Kin Juju Ai.
Graduates of 2023, many congratulations. Ladies and gentlemen, esteemed guests, and graduates of 2023, I stand before you immersed in the pride and the prestige that this day signifies. This congregation for the conferment of degrees is not just a formality, but as I said earlier, it's a passage. It's a testament to your perseverance, your intellect, and the transformative journey here at the University of Strathclyde. Today, we celebrate achievements both personal and collective. Individually, you've surmounted academic rigours with commendable resilience. Many of you have studied during the pandemic restrictions and the lockdown and all the challenges that came with that. But collectively, you're the heirs of an institution that's twice named the Times Higher Education UK University of the Year. The only university so far to ever be named that twice. This university is a beacon that has shone bright since its inception in 1796. And a recent accolade as the Daily Mail Scottish University of the Year for 2024 and her position as the runner-up for UK University of the Year just behind Imperial College are not just laurels that we rest upon. But they're a clarion call to continue our tradition of excellence and service. Many of you have graduated with finance as a major. We have business management. But we also have many of our graduates in lots of other business school subjects like economics and management science and human resource management, international business, business and management. All of your studies here, your education, the approach that we take is anchored in the belief that education is not the filling of a pail, but it's the lighting of a fire. These words, often attributed to a tradition of thought that prizes the ignition of one's internal drive, encapsulate the essence of our pedagogy here at Strathclyde. You've been kindled with the fire of inquiry, business acumen, and innovative leadership. And now you are to carry that flame forward. In the spirit of service to others, I echo the sentiment that the measure of our greatness is the measure of our generosity. You're embarking in careers that demand not only sharp analytical skills, but also large hearts. Economists, finance experts, accountants, marketeers, management scientists, labour experts, entrepreneurs. Each of you is called to serve, to extend your expertise beyond personal success to the upliftment of society. And we stand in the midst of a world grappling with profound issues, climate change foremost among them. Strathclyde's commitment to sustainability is evident in our initiatives, both at the university level and in the business school. And we are leading the charge to a greener, more resilient future. And you, our graduates, will be the standard bearers for this cause, applying your business and economic knowledge to innovate and lead the way in adopting practices that preserve our planet for future generations. It actually doesn't matter what degree that you've studied. The challenges that face the planet affect us all. And the world is relying on you to find solutions, be they technical, financial, or societal. Your time at Strathclyde has also been a time of entrepreneurial spirit, rewarded by our recognition as the European Entrepreneurial University of the Year at the Triple E Awards a few months ago. And that is really special because in a post-Brexit world, for a British university to be awarded a European recognition really tells you about the impact that we are making. And we're the only Scottish business school to be ranked in the Financial Times Executive MBA rankings. And we affirm our dedication to providing a world-class education that is responsive, ethical, and global in its outlook. These honours are a tribute to a university culture that nurtures pioneering thought and action. They speak to the calibre of education that has equipped you to venture boldly into new territories, to found enterprises that not only prosper, but also contribute to the common good. And the world that you enter is complex. It's filled with perils, but it's also filled with possibilities. The dreadful losses of life in Ukraine, Israel, and Palestine challenge the international order and peace. They remind us of the necessity for dialogue, understanding, and the resolution of conflict through compassionate policy, strategic financial management, and innovative marketing strategies. As you step forward, remember that to whom much is given, much is expected. And you have been given much. A top-tier education, a community of scholars, a legacy of leadership, and a fantastic family and friends who are here today. You're expected to rise to the challenges of our time with the strength of your convictions and the breadth of your compassion. Strathclyde has equipped you not just with a degree, but with a compass to navigate the future's unpredictable tides. Please let your careers be the vessels that carry forth the spirit of Strathclyde, a spirit of ambition, boldness, innovation, collaboration, and people orientation. These are our values of this leading international technological university. And as you do so, may you always measure your success not by the positions you occupy, but the differences you make. You're the vanguard of a new era, one that calls for action that transcends the self and embraces the collective. So as we conclude this ceremony, let us not simply move on, but move forward together with the knowledge that every step you take is inscribed with the potential to shape, influence, and redefine the boundaries of what is possible. Graduates of 2023, may the road rise to meet you, and may your actions always reflect the highest ideals of service and unity that we so dearly uphold at Strathclyde. And when we leave the hall today as part of our academic procession, weather permitting, I ask you all to join the procession with pride, Join our staff, our new graduates, and the family members. Join that academic procession as we walk to the learning and teaching building. And let us meet thereafter to celebrate not an end, but a beginning. The commencement of a journey filled with purpose, service, and an unyielding pursuit of a better world. Thank you. Okay, I've had the digital signal there, which is the thumbs up. The weather is good enough. I think it's just good enough. I don't know if the rain is about to come out. But anyway, so that's the end of our ceremony, but it's not the end of the day. I know that you'll all be going on to celebrate with your loved ones. I am also celebrating. My daughter graduated this morning at this morning's ceremony. So like you, I'm a parent, so I'll be heading off once we finish to join them this afternoon. So without further ado, I now declare this congregation for the conferment of degrees closed. I ask you to be upstanding and join us as we process to the learning and teaching building. Thank you very much.